As I was holding Alexis in my arms, my heart filled with love for this tiny miracle. I was in awe of this beautiful gift from God. I held her close to my heart as I rocked her. It was amazing how such a small baby could cause such a marvelous reaction in my heart. I felt the tears pushing their way past my resistance. I quickly handed the baby back to her mother. I could hardly say goodbye to my friend as I walked out the door. What does infertility look like? It looks like me. Actually, infertility looks like anyone and everyone. 1 in 8 Americans are affected by the diseases of infertility. For each couple, their experience will end in 1 of 3 ways. They'll either have a miracle pregnancy, a wonderful adoption, or they'll remain childless. For a variety of reasons.
Statistics reveal that 8 to 12% of men are affected by low fertility and 2% of men are completely sterile. 40% of infertility issues are contributed to male infertility.
Infertility treatments are a $1 billion per year industry. Biological reasons for infertility include tubal factors, ovulatory disorders, and endometriosis. But 40% of infertility issues and miscarriage are caused by unknown factors.
It's not about blame. It's not about choice. It's about the pain of infertility.
Even a walk through my neighborhood is a painful reminder that my daughter can't conceive. Her childlessness will leave me grandchildless.
Of the millions of childless couples trying to adopt, many of them will fill their homes with wonderful children through adoption. But for every couple trying to adopt a child, there are 36 children waiting for adoption. It's no wonder so many couples find themselves unable to adopt. There are approximately 5.7 million childless couples in the United States. And while some of them chose not to have children, over half can't. We became one of those families when uterine cancer stole our chances of becoming pregnant, and circumstances beyond our control took adoption off the table.
Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? And what if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? And what if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise?
There was hope for my broken heart. There was healing, and God still had a plan and purpose for my life. He brought us through every step of our journey through infertility, and we knew He would use our childless life if we gave it to Him. We couldn't just dismiss the desires of our heart, but we allowed the Lord to work in our hearts and heal our pain. Beside the Empty Cradle is more than our story. It's a guidebook to take couples through their infertility journey, even if their journey doesn't conclude with a miracle pregnancy or a blessed adoption story. It's about hope and healing, but more than anything, It's about finding peace with God's plan for your life, even when it wasn't your plan. For more information and resources, visit BesideTheEmptyCradle.com.